Today's video is going to be about AOA, also known as angle of attack. Consider this scenario. Airflow in upper and lower part of the wing is imbalanced. This will cause the jet to completely stall and unable to fly. This is where angle of attack comes to decide how much air should pass below the wings and above the wings. Another term that is used to refer to angle of attack is known as alpha. Alpha is used more often when technical or academic discussions are taking place, whereas angle of attack is a more commonly used term in practical aviation settings. Angle of attack in a fighter jet is the angle between the incoming air and the wing chord line, which is an imaginary line that connects the wing's leading edge and trailing edge. It determines how much lift the wings generate and how much drag they produce. This allows the pilot to control the speed of the aircraft, its altitude, and also its maneuverability. Angle of attack is measured with the help of sensors on the wings and is displayed on the aircraft's heads-up display. High angle of attack generates more lift, but it also produces more drag, which can slow down the aircraft. Low angle of attack produces less lift and drag, allowing the jet to fly faster and perform aggressive maneuvers. In F-18, angle of attack sensors are usually located on the leading edge of the wings, near the wing root. F-18 also has an AOA indexer, which displays green, yellow and red light to help pilot maintain the correct angle of attack. It also has a flight control system that automatically adjusts the aircraft's control surfaces to maintain a safe and stable AOA. The angle of attack sensor in F-35 jet is found in the pitot tube of the aircraft around the nose cone. It also has a digital angle of attack indexer to visually aid the pilot in maintaining the correct angle of attack. The flight control system in the F-35 is designed to automatically adjust the control surfaces to maintain a safe and stable AOA, and to prevent the aircraft from entering an aerodynamic stall. Slats, as we know, are movable surfaces found on the leading edge of the wings designed to increase the lift. When slats move up and down, the airflow between the upper and lower side of the wings is adjusted, helping in maintaining the angle of attack. They work in conjunction with angle of attack in order to ensure a smooth and attached flow of air over the wings, even at high angle of attack. At high angles of attack, the airflow over the top of the wing can separate from the surface, causing a loss of lift and an increase in drag. Slats prevent this by creating a gap between the leading edge of the wings and the slats itself. This allows high pressure air from below the wing to flow over the top of the slat. As the angle of attack increases, the slats move forward and downward, increasing the size of the slot and allowing more high-pressure air to flow over the wing. This helps to generate more lift and maintain the aircraft's stability and control at low speeds. Angle of attack is certainly an important concept for the pilot to make sure that the aircraft is always in control and the flight is safe.